Hello, multi-universe maltmates.
Hello indeed. Welcome, maltmates, to another on-location Ralphy review. This time we're at the epicentre, the headquarters of the Creative Whiskey Company, where we will also find a small boutique independent bottler by the name of North Star. Now, I'm making myself useful today, sort of helping Ian to do some labelling on his bottles. Ian is the proprietor, and rather than me tell you about North Star Whiskey Company, I think it's probably better coming from Ian. Over to you, Ian. These are the malt mates, and they want to hear what you have to say.
Okay, thank you, Ralph. My name is Ian. This is the North Star Spirits. We started North Star in March 2016. It was previous to that, I worked for Mr. Morrison at AD Rattray. Learned a few bits and bobs there, and then decided to go it on my own. This is now, what is it now? It's 2018, so that's me nearly 2 years trading on my fourth series of single casks, some bourbon in there as well. And I've got my Santa's little helper today to get the labels on straight.
Yes, I was going to come to that actually. I've just been checking the bottles, Ian. Yeah. So if you can keep up with production here, you know. The labels are reasonably straight. If you ever come across a North Star bottling that doesn't have a straight label, don't worry about it. It's boutique and authentic.
That one's a wee bit skew-iff, but...
We've got wriggle room here.
That'll do.
It's not a large production line, for the simple reason that you're dealing with more or less one cask at a time. Bottled, and I've been reading these labels, Ian, bottled at a higher strength, cask strength, for this Altmore 11-year-old. Age statement, do you know how I do approve of these things? Unchill filtered and natural colour.
Natural colour, yeah.
Right, too.
No funny business with our whiskies, straight from the barrel into the bottle. Maybe sometimes a little bit of ambient filtering just to get rid of any kind of wood chips or bits of burnt kind of, you know, all the bits that you get inside a cask.
Cask residue,
yeah.
Perfectly natural.
So, but no, all the fats, Easter's oils, the cloudiness, all that is, to me, flavour. And that's what makes us unique. Mm-hmm. You know, so with a cask, it's only a small yield, so every cask is different. So that's what we love at North Star, something unique and small batch.
Absolutely, and I've actually been looking out for a bottle of Ian's whiskey to review, and what I've noticed. What's this? Oh, lovely! Oh, wonderful! You won't be able to see it, malt mates, but you can actually see some little particles of barley. It's basically barley protein cask oil, and it tends to form little, like almost snowflakes inside the bottle. I can just reassure you, by the way, if you ever see this, it's actually a sign of better intrinsic quality, and it's perfectly natural. And occasionally at the bottom of the bottle, you'll also see a little dusting of what looks like sawdust. And again, that is perfectly natural leftovers from barrier filtering without excessive filtration going on. Good stuff.
Well, that's a 12-year-old single cask Ardbeg, Ralphie.
Ardbeg.
So this is like sweet gunpowder, if there is such a thing.
Well, it's been a while since I've had some sweet gunpowder. There we go. There you are, Mom. That's it. Ardbeg. 12 years old. Don't see much of that. I'm going to push this case out of the way and bring up another case. Hopefully the right empty case.
Yeah, I've got just the Ardbeg here.
Right, so. Too. And the labels are fairly straight. Yep, looking good.
Are they? Right.
Yes, I'm happy
with
it.
Thank you. As long as it's passed the test over at the north end of the table, I'm happy.
And so it's a real variety of whiskies that you're bottling, Ian. And not just whiskies, I have noticed some American bourbon.
Yeah, we bottled a 13-year-old bourbon, well, Tennessee whiskey. mm-hmm. from a certain whiskey based in it's in Tennessee that I'm not allowed to mention. But
nobody heard.
But with each cast series, Ralph, what I tried to do is try my very best to look after something from every region, which ultimately then gives you something round about different taste profiles, mm-hmm. And ultimately something that I find really important is every budget as well. You know, if I'm just releasing single cast 37-year-old Boonahabans or 12-year-old Arbegs, you know, not everybody can afford these. So, mm-hmm. you know, 11-year-old Altmores, they speak to a lot larger audience, which mm-hmm. I think is super important.
So. Absolutely, and this is the benefit, just to remind you malt mates, that I do take an interest in the smaller, what we sometimes call boutique bottlers, for the reason that particularly if you're getting a gift for a whiskey friend, are you looking for something more unusual or an unusual version of a single malt you might be aware of, like an Ardbeg, then it's the small bottlers are where you'll find these experiences. And it's not necessarily going to be too expensive. Of course, there's a premium, particularly depending on the way we go. This is where I start, excuse me, this is where I start boxing up. There is occasionally a premium depending on the reputation of a single malt. But at the same time, it's not just your Ardbegs and Macallans and Springbanks that you occasionally see from independent bottlers. There's other single malt distilleries like Strathmill Chiananich Altmore, for example. I know in my journey through warehouses here, there and everywhere, you know, there's some stunningly good, interesting, characterful whiskies. And where you tend to find them in the bottle shop is in these smaller independent bottlers like North Star, which is why when Ian invited me to give him a helpy hand, not too much, just enough, I said absolutely, make myself useful while I'm here. Thank you very much.
I believe your hourly rate is pretty, I heard it's negotiable.
It's pretty well non-existent because it still remains, after 9 years as a whiskey reviewer, a passion project for me, a self-funding hobby. Oh, jeez, oh, bloody. Oh, that was going to tip.
It's happened 100 times. If I had a penny for how many bottles I've spilt.
Spilt? How many have you smashed?
Oh, many.
Yeah. I've dropped one in the Manx bothy, but I've never actually smashed it. It bounced.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I've smashed millions of. I've spilt casks.
Millions,
I've
I don't
spilt,
believe you.
Well, not millions, but more than I would like to own up to.
Right.
One of the joys of going to fairs and festivals around the world here.
Doesn't sound like much of a joy to me, but I'll take your word for it.
So that is the Ardbeg. That is that. I think we're going to drop this off at Good Spirits, maybe today.
In Glasgow, yes.
In Glasgow, aye. We're going to do some deliveries after this. But the next one we're going to bottle is... a nice little 37-year-old Boonahabin. Mm-hmm. This is a really interesting story with this one, Ralph. It's I bought quite a few casks from the 70s that were below strength. Uh-huh. They were below 40%, which obviously you can't call whiskey. And they were quite a small yield as well. What we did was we married them all together and I mixed them with a cask of 1980 Boona that I sourced. So this isn't a single cask, this one. This is a vatting mm-hmm. of Boonahabin, single malt, but just a little mix there. So it's something a little bit different. It's, you know, it's distilled May 1980, which is not yesterday. So mm-hmm. this is made in a, you know, a working class environment by a working class man many, many moons ago. And, you know, I'm kind of blessed with the job now to put a nice label on it, mm-hmm. speak to you about it, and drive it up to Glasgow and yeah. give it to the guys in the Good Spirit Company. So we're very lucky.
Fantastic. I tell you what, we get, I might even buy a bottle myself, because this happens now and again. Barrels, there's that many casks in a warehouse that sometimes they can get forgotten about, overlooked, and the actual strength ABV volume of alcohol drops below 40%, and therefore it can no longer be called Scotch whiskey, because by law it must be a minimum 40% volume for the flavour. However, the actual flavour at 39, 38, 35% volume can be tremendous. But then it's up to the bottler to blend up not so much the flavour of that single malt, but the strength, the alcoholic ABV, by mixing it with a younger single malt, which is far higher strength, and therefore together the strength goes above 40%. worth looking out for and worth being aware of. But I think that's enough for a moment. Ian, thank you very much indeed.
No problem.
We've got to crack on and get this job done.
Yeah.
We'd love to chat to you a little bit more, but we are kind of busy, malt mates, so bear with us. I think we'll do a part two here.
Sounds good.
Okay, okay.
There's some duty stamps to put on.
Duty stamps. Oh, my. They've got to put them on. If you do not have a duty stamp on a bottle of alcoholic beverage, you're in big trouble. So we've got to be aware of that. It means I'm going to have to take the whiskey back out of the boxes again, but never mind. We'll be back shortly with another extras. Bear with us, malt mates. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.